Good morning, friends. In last lecture, we see the concept of voltage relations. Okay, we see the voltage relations with respect to lagging load, with respect to leading load, and with respect to unity power factor.
रघुवीर
बाहर कुछ जेवायला जायचं नाय कुठे काय
Somebody call to Raghuveer. विनोद कॉल टू रघुवीर अँड से टू म्यूट
सर करतो सर लगेच करतो
ओके आय थिंक प्रॉब्लेम इज सॉर्ट आउट नाउ ओके सो टुडे वी स्टार्ट द मेथड्स ऑफ व्होल्टेज रेग्युलेशन्स इन मेथड्स ऑफ व्होल्टेज रेग्युलेशन्स वी कॅल्क्युलेट द voltage regulations anyhow okay so to calculate the voltage regulations first of all the formula is eph minus vt okay upon vt means what alternator is based upon the full load voltage okay its voltage regulation is based upon the full load voltage means anyhow to we have to calculate the voltage regulations by calculations of eph by calculations of vt okay so how can I calculate this eph and vt okay this is the biggest question okay with respect to voltage regulations so these are the some methods okay to calculate the voltage regulations of alternator and the these methods is also performed in your practical labs okay there are two practicals based on this voltage regulation techniques okay we are in the practical you also clear the concept of how you can calculate the voltage regulations okay so let's see so what are the different classifications of voltage regulations first of all we see the direct loading test and indirect loading test okay the first two main methods of voltage regulations is direct loading test and indirect loading test direct loading test is a conventional method okay we can directly connect load to the alternator then after some times we can just thrown off the load okay and we calculate load voltage and no load voltage so this is the simple technique and conventional technique in this technique we can't consider that is excitations what is the speed okay so this is not give the accurate answer to you and this method is just for a small alternators which is rated that less than 5 kVA okay we see this method in details don't worry about that after that indirect methods so indirect methods again classified into three types first is the synchronous impedance method second is the ampere turn methods and third is the zero power factor methods okay synchronous methods is also called as the emf methods why it is called as the emf method we will see in the next slides that is ampere turn method is also called as a emf method and most important method with respect to voltage regulations of the alternator that is Fourier triangle motor this is the most accurate method with respect to the all methods okay so this is a very much important with respect to your calculation of voltage regulation many times in the practical applications we use this Fourier triangle methods because it gives you a very accurate voltage regulations okay so these are the types of voltage regulations now first thing is the direct loading test okay so first classification is direct loading test now in direct loading test as you just observe this diagram okay this is the arrangement to calculate the voltage regulations okay why it is called as a direct loading test here just carefully observe this diagram here I connect directly this three phase load to this alternator okay this is your armature winding okay RYP star connected armature winding that's why neutral is present okay in between R phase and in between neutral I connect that is voltmeter okay again that is your R phase is connected to the your directly load, and here I give a switches. Okay, why I provide these switches? Because I have to calculate full load voltage and no load voltage. This is the simple concept. Atharva. So your load is connected to this alternator. Okay, for this purpose, to calculate full load voltage and no load voltage, I provide here switches. Okay, this is the only concept. Next is the, this is your field winding. Actually, this diagram, this part is present here. Okay, because it is make very high distance, very large distance. Okay, because your field excitation is nearly to the your alternator. So this is your prime mover. Okay, this is your field winding, and this field winding is excited by the your field winding. Your field winding is excited by the DC supply. Okay, to maintain the synchronism. So this is the total arrangement. Now, how can I load? How can I calculate a terminal voltage, and how can I calculate EPH? First of all, I understood in direct loading test, this test is only applicable for small alternator. Okay, small alternator in the case that is which is less than 5 kVA. Okay, the first and important point with respect to direct loading test is it is used for less than 5 kVA. Okay, then next point is, first of all, I just connect this load. Okay, I connect this load. Okay, after connections of load, then I close this switch. Okay, now I start the direct loading test. Okay, carefully observe the procedure. First of all, I close this switch. When I connect this load to this your alternator, then here I give a rated voltage and rated current. How can I maintain this rated voltage and rated current? Because as you know that in the starting, okay, the starting your excitation should be zero. Okay, slowly I increase these excitations. Okay, and I enhance the excitation in a such a way that to maintain a rated voltage. Okay, okay. As I know that is the rated voltage of the alternator. First of all, I calculate the rated voltage by maintaining the excitations and speed constants. Okay, then I calculate your VT. Okay, and how can I maintain armature current? Also by using this your field current. Field current is nothing but the which is related to the flux, that is your field excitations. Okay, means initially I just maintain the rated voltage and rated current. Okay, to calculate this terminal voltage. Okay, but as you know that there are three types of drop present in the alternator. Which type of drop? That is armature reactions drop, then your leakage reactance drop, then your armature resistance drop. Okay, so to overcome this drop, okay, to overcome this drop, I added here more excitations. Okay, then I get the rated voltage, that is VT. In this way I can calculate VT. What is the most important point? Ya tikani tumhala he je kai VT ahe, VT madhe kai tri drop honar, because load connect kelela ahe. Load connect kelela ahe means what? Tya tikani EPH is not equal to VT asnar ahe. Okay, EPH is not equal to VT. I already told you this concept in case in the unit number 1, that is alternator on no load and load. On load conditions, EPH is never equal to VT. But anyhow, to maintain this terminal voltage, rated voltage, I have to excite these field excitations. Okay, up to rated voltage, and I calculate the value of VT. Okay, after that, I just disconnect this load. Okay, I use here the switches, and I just disconnect this load by opening this switch. Okay, if I disconnect this load again, I maintain the increase the field excitation slowly. Okay, and calculate EPH, that is no load voltage. EPH calculation is very easy to calculate because there is no concern of load. Okay, if there is a load come into the picture, then that is the problem. Okay, means you consider all types of losses. Okay, with respect to the load, whether your load is lagging load, whether your load is leading load, or your load is unity power factor. So, but with respect to no load, with respect to no load voltage, I just disconnect this load and calculate EPH. In this way, I can calculate VT and EPH. After calculation of VT and EPH, I just put this value into the formula and I calculate voltage regulations. Okay. So this is the procedure. In this direct loading test, what is the most important thing? First thing is the your diagram. Your diagram should be neat and clean. Okay. If you understood this diagram, you can easily write the explanations. Okay. Or the whatever be the information. Okay. So this is the method which is used to for less than 5 kVA. I already explained all these points. Okay. 5 kVA. So here I use a rated speed terminal voltage. Okay. By using field excitations. And when I disconnect the load, okay, my excitations with same excitations and speed, I calculate the EPH. So by using these two techniques, close and open the switch, I just calculate the EPH minus VPH upon EPH into 100. So this is my percentage voltage regulations. In this way, I can calculate direct loading test. Okay, this is whatever be the your load. Okay, with respect to load, I can follow this same procedure. Okay, this is very general procedure. Whether you consider transformer, whether you consider your DC motor or induction motor, I can, if I calculate voltage regulations, I use same procedure. First of all, I connect the load and then I disconnect the load. Means this is the very conventional way I can calculate the voltage regulations. Okay, so I hope you understood this concept. Okay, now the next is the indirect methods. Okay, so these indirect methods, so this is your indirect methods. So in this indirect methods is classified into three types. First is the synchronous impedance method, ampere turn method, and Fourier triangle method. Okay, to understand these three methods or to calculate the voltage regulations by using three methods, first of all, we understand what are the parameters which is required to calculate this method. Okay, so initially we calculate what are the parameters which is required to this indirect method. Okay, so data required for indirect methods are, what is the data to calculate the indirect methods? The three most important parameter which is calculated in the indirect methods. So first calculation is armature resistance. Okay, first calculation is armature resistance is important to calculate the indirect methods. Second thing is open circuit voltage or open circuit test, that is VOC. Then your short circuit test. Okay, you already conduct this test, that is open circuit test and short circuit test in your transformer. Okay, transformer we perform open circuit test and short circuit test. Now first of all, you tell me, if I want to calculate armature resistance, okay, then tell me what are the way to calculate the resistance. In general way, you can tell me. Please tell me what are the way to calculate armature resistance. Ajinkya, tell me fast. You already covered these topics in measurement. Okay, as you know that you calculate low resistance, medium resistance, high resistance. Okay, I just give the hint to you. Tell me, how can I calculate any resistance? What are the methods?
By multimeter, volt ampere method.
Okay, volt ampere methods. Again, volt ampere method is used for medium resistance or low resistance or high resistance, Pramod?
Medium resistance.
And what are the methods which is used for high resistance?
Megger.
Okay, very good. Megger. And for low resistance?
Bridges, Wheatstone bridge.
Wheatstone bridge or double Wheatstone bridge?
No, sir.
Okay, you don't have any idea. Okay. For medium resistance and high resistance, you give the correct answer. Somebody tell me, for to calculate the low resistance, how can I calculate low resistance? What are the instrument? Fast.
Kelvin bridge.
Kelvin bridge. Okay. Okay. This is the part with respect to your electrical and measurement instrument subject. Okay. So armature resistance is in the category of medium resistance. Okay. As you see in the numericals, we solve different types of numerical. In the numericals, you observe that 4 ohm, 5 ohm, okay, 1.2 ohm, 5.2 ohm. These are the values of armature resistance. Okay. By this observation, you can tell that this category is in the medium range. Okay, so that's why I just give you a small introductions about the measurement of resistance. So write down for low resistance. Okay, for low resistance we use double Wheatstone bridge. Sometimes in the objective questions they ask the question, these questions. Okay, double Wheatstone bridge. Okay, so this question is also asked in the your junior engineer exam or DRD or ISRO exams. Okay, then for medium resistance, which type of instrument are used? In medium resistance, we use Wheatstone bridge. Okay, there is a difference between double Wheatstone bridge and Wheatstone bridge. Okay, double Wheatstone bridge is used for a small resistance. Wheatstone bridge is used for a medium resistance. Again, that is a voltage ammeter technique or ammeter voltage technique. Then again, there is a substitution method is there. Okay, again we for the high resistance. Okay, for high resistance we use Megger. This is one of the famous example to calculate high resistance. We use Megger instrument. Okay, so these are the some instruments with respect to the resistance. Now we just focus upon the armature resistance, because armature resistance in the medium range, that's why here I use the voltage ammeter technique. Okay, voltmeter ammeter technique is used to calculate the armature resistance. Everybody is quite familiar with the voltmeter ammeter techniques. I think you perform one practical depend upon this technique. Okay, now the next technique is VOC. Okay, now tell me, what is the use of open circuit test in case of transformer? What is the purpose in case of transformer?
To determine iron losses.
To determine iron losses. Excellent answer. Okay. And what is the use of short circuit test on the transformer?
Copper losses.
Copper losses. Very good.
No copper losses.
Okay. These two tests are very important with respect to transformer or any other machines. Okay. In transformer, we use open circuit test and short circuit test to calculate the your iron losses and copper losses. Okay. Because iron losses and copper losses decide the rating of your transformer. Okay, because to design any machines or any transformer, any static machines or dynamic machines, what are the two components for the designing aspect to very important? First thing is your losses. How much losses is present is important. Okay, to design any machines, whether it is a static or dynamic. And what is the second point? That is cooling technique. Okay, how can I use the cooling methods, okay, which can effectively work in the any machines? So these two points are very important for designing perspective. Okay, so this technique is very famous technique, that is open circuit test. In the alternator we use VOC, and in short circuit test we use ISC, that is short circuit current. Okay, by using these two tests. Okay, first of all we see armature resistance. How can I calculate armature resistance? That is the question for me. Okay, so this is the arrangement. I think you are very familiar with this arrangement, because in measurement this is the same arrangement. Only the difference is here I connect one load. Okay, here I connect one load, here I connect current coil, then here I connect pressure coil. As you remember this diagram, the pressure coil, and after connection of this instrument, I can easily calculate this voltmeter, and by using voltmeter and ammeter the resistance, medium resistance, high resistance. Okay. Akshay, do you have any doubt with respect to this technique? Akshay Shevade. Akshay. Okay. So this is the techniques which is used to calculate the armature resistance. So how can I calculate armature resistance? That is the question. Okay. So this is your alternator. The alternator, this is three phase winding, that is R winding, Y winding, and P. Okay, three phase. In between two phase, just carefully observe this diagram. In between two phase, I connect voltmeter. Okay, and here I connect ammeter. Okay, to calculate voltage and to calculate current. Okay, rated current. I just connect this voltmeter and ammeter. Now, how can I calculate this resistance? That is your armature resistance, RRY. Okay. So as you know that this VDC1 and IDC1, if I connect here DC supply, okay. If I connect, that is your, because in field winding, okay. In field winding, we use the DC supply. Okay. That's why here I connect one DC supply here. After connection of DC supply, I measure the voltage. Okay. The measure the voltage, that is line voltage, because this voltage is present between two lines. So this is called as a line voltage. So VDC1, this VDC1, how can I calculate VDC1? Here I connect two probe here, connect here, and by using voltmeter, I calculate VDC1. Same way, I calculate IDC1 by using ammeter. Okay. It is the ratio of VDC1 upon IDC1. I get the value of RRY. That is your resistance, first resistance. Okay. Same. This is the first, that is resistance between RRY. Okay. So to calculate RYB. So RYB. What is the formula? That is VDC2 upon ITC2. Okay. First of all, I calculate voltage resistance in between R and Y. Okay. According to this formula. Second time I calculate RYB resistance.
Sir.
Yes.
RYB check karatana voltmeter and ammeter chi position change karayche ka hai tashi thevayche sir.
Nahi nahi change karav lagel na. With respect to tum
change karayche na.
Yes yes. I just give one example. Okay. To for calculation purpose. To calculate first RRY, here I connect voltmeter. Okay. And here I connect ammeter. Okay. After calculation of RRY. Okay. After calculation of RRY, I calculate RYB. How can I calculate RYB? I just put voltmeter here. It's already, I give this, do this arrangement. Okay. So voltmeter present here, ammeter present here. So that is VDC2 upon IDC2. Okay. So this is the arrangement RYB. Last, that is RB. That is RRB. Okay, how can I calculate VDC3 upon IDC3? I think some students are quite confused with this. How, sir, here DC voltage supply is given, because as you know that on armature is present on a stator, okay, and on field and on rotor, field winding is present. To excite the field winding, I give the DC supply. So this DC supply is here. Okay, I just calculate this DC supply. First of all, so this is the way I can calculate all three resistance. After calculations of all three resistance, I just take average, okay, and calculate this RDC. Okay, so this is the formula. This formula is derived in the case of skin effect. Okay, I think you are quite familiar with this skin effect. Do you know the concept of skin effect? Hello, Pratik. Pratik, tell me what is meant by skin effect. Pratik Danane, I am audible to you. Hello, Pratik.
Yes, sir.
Do you know the concept of skin effect? एनीबडी फ्रॉम यू आई थिंक
मैक्सिमम टेंडेंसी ऑफ करंट कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड
म्हणजे कंडक्टरच्या आउटर साइड ने जास्त करंट फ्लो होतो सेंटर मध्ये करंट फ्लो नाही होत
ओके ओके
आउटर लेअर ऑफ कंडक्टर
हाई फ्रिक्वेन्सी अल्टरनेटर करंट फ्लो होतो सर
सर जेव्हा सप्लाय 30 केव्ही पेक्षा जास्त जातो ना
हा येस येस राहुल स्पीक अप तेव्हा स्किन इफेक्ट होतो बर अजून अजून कोण सांगू शकतं दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पॉवर सिस्टम and this question is asked in every exam almost in every exam you can refer any online exam okay with respect to your competitive exam
maximum tendency of current concentrated near to the surface of the conductor in alternating current
okay so many students
sir manje jo conductor asto na conductor cha jo madhya bhag asto na tichyatun current as flow hot nahi
okay ओके
म्हणजे फ्रिक्वेन्सी वाढते मग त्याच्यामुळे डायमीटर वाढून जातो
ओके ओके व्हेरी गुड अप्रोच एव्हरीवन ट्राय टू गिव द आंसर ऑफ स्किन इफेक्ट आय जस्ट एक्सप्लेन इन ब्रीफ वे ओके व्हाट इज स्किन इफेक्ट स्किन इफेक्ट व्हेन आय गिव अ सायनोसॉइडल वेव टू द एनी कंडक्टर दॅट टाइम देर इज अ नॉन युनिफॉर्म डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ऑफ युअर इलेक्ट्रिक इंटेन्सिटी ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ कंडक्टर ओके and maximum current is passing through the surface of conductor okay so this is your skin effect okay now this skin effect enhances the value of resistance okay ac resistance because always keep in mind that in dc transmission there is a no skin effect okay because in dc transmission there is no alternating current is there that's why there is no skin effect that's why I always tell that skin effect present in the dc or armature resistance okay that is rdc there are two types of resistance one is the ac resistance and second is the dc resistance now this rac resistance okay rac resistance is always greater than rdc resistance somebody if you interview they ask why rac resistance is greater than rdc resistance sometimes they directly ask you the skin effect how they ask you in a such a way that if there is any power transmission based company they ask you that why ac resistance is always greater than dc resistance so the answer is because of skin effect the current is passing through the circumferences of your circle or a conductor that's why your ac resistance enhances because at the center okay your rac resistance is very high than the rdc resistance then what is the relation between rac and rdc So the general relation is your armature resistance or your AC resistance is always 1.25 to 1.5 is greater than DC resistance. Okay, so this is the relations. Means what is the skin effect is depend upon? Skin effect is depend upon frequency. First thing is, second thing is permeability. Okay, these two factor which affect the skin effect. Because in DC transmission line, frequency is zero. That's why there is no concern of skin effect. So in this way, I can calculate this RDC resistance. Okay, by using this your armature resistance. If I calculate RDC resistance, okay, then I easily calculate armature resistance. How? Armature resistance is 1.25 to 1.5 times of RDC. First of all, I calculate RDC resistance. Okay. After that, I just use this relations that armature resistance is always 1.25 times that RDC. Okay, RDC is already calculated. Just divide, multiply with 1.25, whatever the value of RDC, then we get armature resistance. Okay, what is my aim? My aim is to be calculate armature resistance. Okay, so this is the way we can calculate armature resistance. I hope you understood this techniques. Okay, because this is very simple. You already covered in the your measurement subject okay but only point don't misconcept with this rdc okay why rdc is present here first of all I calculate rdc because it is very easy to calculate rdc which is present on the field winding after the relation between ra and rdc I just calculate armature resistance so this is the concept okay After that, the next is your measurement of open circuit voltage. Okay. Now, how can I calculate this open circuit voltage? What is the procedure to calculate the open circuit voltage? So, first of all, that is VOC. Okay. I have to calculate VOC, that is open circuit voltage. Now, what is the procedure? Okay. So, this is your alternator. This alternator is give 230 volt DC supply. 230 volt DC supply means what? This is your field excitation. Okay. And this is your VOC. Okay. Now, what is the procedure? How can I calculate VOC? The first step is initially maintain field current is equal to zero. Okay. Just observe the simultaneously diagram. You can easily understood this diagram. Okay. This is your OCC characteristic. What is OCC characteristics? That is open circuit characteristics. You already learned this concept in DC machines. Okay. I just repeat the concept. That is, first of all, you maintain field current zero. After maintaining the field current zero means what? You initially, there is no excitation present on the alternator. Then after some times, you just start the alternator, okay, under open circuit and slowly increase the value of field current. If you increase the value of field current, okay, then your rated voltage is also increased, okay. That is EPH. Okay. Now maintain the rated voltage by using the field excitations. Okay. Increase the field excitation in this way to maintain your rated voltage. Okay. Some students have doubt with respect to how can I know the value of rated voltage. Already on the nameplate of the alternator, okay, designer mentioned the value of rated voltage. Suppose I consider 415 volt is the rated voltage. So how can I maintain this value? I can maintain this value by using field current. I increase the field current in a such a way that, just observe this diagram. I can maintain this field current in a such a way that I get the rated voltage. So this is the way I can maintain the field current. Now, this is your star connection. As star connection is concerned, this is the relation, that is EPH is equal to EL by root 3. So EL is equal to root 3 EPH because of the star connections. Okay. So this is the some important points with respect to alternator. Now, second times, I increase the field current in a such a way that I get maximum open circuit voltage. Okay. By increase the value of field current. Okay. So these are the some steps which is required to calculate open circuit voltage. Just see this diagram. So I just read the points, some important points with respect to this calculation. First of all, alternator is drive at a rated speed with the help of prime mover and armature terminals are kept open. Okay. Because open circuit test is there. I already opened this armature terminals. Okay. Initially, your excitations or field current must be zero. This is the most important conditions after the open circuit of armature terminal. Third is the field current is then gradually increased, as I told you, in steps, and terminal voltage is measured at each step. Okay. You can get the values. Okay. Then excitations current may be increased up to 25% to 50% more than the rated voltage of the alternator. Whatever be the rated voltage of the alternator, I already achieve the rated voltage of the alternator. How? Just see this graph. Okay. In this graph, this is your rated voltage. Okay. So this is your rated voltage. What is the procedure? I increase the 25% to 30% more field current than the your rated current. If I consider 3.5 ampere is my rated current. Okay. Let's consider. Okay. 3.5 is my rated current. So 20 to 30% of 3.5. Okay. Means near about your 5 to 6 ampere current is increases, okay, by using field excitations and calculate your open circuit voltage. Okay. After calculations of open circuit voltage, then what is the next step? A graph is plotted between open circuit phase voltage and field current. Okay. And the x-axis field current is present and on y-axis open circuit voltage is present. Okay. So these are the ओपन सर्किट वोल्टेज एंड फील्ड करंट. नाउ दिस कर्व इज कॉल्ड एज अ ओपन सर्किट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स कर्व. ओके सो नाउ आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट बिकॉज ऑफ वी कैलकुलेट वीओसी. ओके वीओसी देन इन सम इंटरव्यू दे आस्क व्हाट इज मीन बाय ओपन सर्किट कर्व. समटाइम्स यू कंफ्यूज विथ what is the relations between open circuit curve to draw the open circuit curve. So it is very easy that when there is graph between on x axis field current and your open circuit voltage that is EPH. So this give you the open circuit characteristics. Okay, always remember that your field is present on x axis and EPH is present on y axis to perform the open circuit characteristic. Same way I can explain short circuit characteristic, that is short circuit current. Okay, I think you get the idea. After only the replacement of EPH by ISC, I can calculate the ICC. Okay, that is short circuit current. Okay, so in this way I can calculate VOC. Okay, I think you understood this concept. If you are not understood, write down in the chat box. I will repeat once again this procedure. Okay, that is not the biggest issue. So I think 1 minute is remaining. Okay, somebody take the screenshot of our attendance and send me. Okay, so in the today's lecture, I cover first is the